Ladies and gentlemen, let me at the outset extend a very warm welcome to all of you to the Silver Jubilee celebrations of the Public Affairs Center. If you were to visit the PAC campus in Jigni, there is a palpable excitement in the air. Smiles radiate on every researcher as each speaks with pride of the work she does. The discussions of the senior team on the impact of our projects are suffused with a sense of accomplishment. Whether the head of research, the head of policy engagement, or the head of data analytics, that is Dr. Meena Nair, Dr. Annapurna, and Dr. Asha Subramanian respectively, each speaks with a newfound resolve, commitment, and creativity. I use the word she, the feminine gender, advisedly. She literally subsumes he, and also because we are proud that over 60% of the PAC team comprises women. If you stepped into our board meeting, comprising as it does of board members of distinction, vision, and commitment, you observe a quiet sense of resolve. The discussions ponder the future, hopes, dreams, new beginnings. This is a time for celebration, and it is my pleasure to welcome all of you today. Dr. Kasturi Rangan, Chairman of the Board of PAC, has graciously agreed to deliver the inaugural address. It is my privilege, sir, to welcome you this evening. Two of the co-founders of the Public Affairs Center, Professor K.R.S. Murthy and Mr. P.P. Madappa, have also graciously accepted our invitation to speak on this occasion, and it's my pleasure to welcome both of them. Milestones are important in life. They represent the culmination of hard work, a sense of fulfillment for investing a part of ourselves into a cause that is larger than oneself. They also symbolize change and progress. But perhaps more than everything else, milestones compel us to reflect on the future, the challenges, the possibilities, and the adventure. It is important to celebrate milestones. As the director of Public Affairs Center, I realized that I was in a unique position to create space to celebrate the Silver Jubilee, to pause on the day-to-day responsibilities and recognize those that have put their shoulder to the wheel and helped achieve something noteworthy. PAC is today a leader in its own right. People listen when we speak. Therefore, it is important, I thought, to command attention towards those important people and events in a manner that validates the remarkable contributions and accomplishments in the 25-year journey of Public Affairs Center. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me the liberty to briefly reminisce. On Dr. Samuel Paul, who is the reason we are all here today, I will not say much. I would urge all of you to read the fascinating commemorative volume that is being released by our chairman today. It contains 25 essays to commemorate 25 years of PAC and presents a brilliant portrait of Dr. Samuel Paul, the man, the vision, and the institution. I want to begin by acknowledging first and above all else, Mrs. Lily Paul, who opened her home to the PAC as its first office and offered her dining table as the first workstation. She is here. A round of applause for Mrs. Lily Paul. In her quiet, unobtrusive way, she managed the home and family for the next 20 years allowing Dr. Paul the time and the energy to devote himself to public life. Without this, PAC might not have been what it is. Not many of you might know that she created an exquisite stained glass piece of art that adorns the wall outside the director's office today. In the fall of 2008, a great jurist and perhaps the most erudite of men, Justice M.N. Venkatachalaya, took over as the chair of the board of PAC. For 9 long years till 2017, he guided the destiny of PAC with sagacity and infused it with the inspiration to transform from an institution that engaged in diagnostic studies to undertaking action research. PAC was fortunate, and I, as the director, doubly so, to have had the benefit of the indefatigable and infectious optimism and the sage counsel of our former chairman. And we expect that he will be joining us a little later this evening. A few others among Dr. Paul's friends who shared the fierce commitment to social accountability that he envisioned joined him as co-founders. They played a foundational role in building PAC. I want to acknowledge Professor K.R.S. Murthy and Professor Mrs. Nirmala Murthy. They are an inseparable part of the PAC journey. Professor Murthy remains engaged and provides PAC the guidance to excel. Similarly, I want to acknowledge Mr. P.P. Madappa and Mrs. Aslesha Madappa, whose home was the venue of many animated discussions leading up to the establishment of Public Affairs Center. As a matter of fact, the name and logo of the PAC, now rather well known, were the contributions of Mrs. Madappa. Mr. Sudhakar Rao is here, former Chief Secretary of the Government of Karnataka, Chairman of Public Affairs Foundation, and member of the PAC Board. He has been a strength, not just to me, but to Public Affairs Center. So I want to acknowledge him, as well as Dr. Ravindra, former Chief Secretary again, whose contributions to PAC are truly noteworthy. Amongst the early employees of PAC, I must acknowledge first the first employee, Shanti Shetty. Together with her, Sheila Prem Kumar and Sita Shekhar. Sita and I go back many years because when I was in the government and Sita was in the PAC, one of the important projects that the PAC had done was actually to help reform the business environment in Karnataka. And I recall I was Commissioner Industries at the time, and Sita was the lead researcher from the Public Affairs Center. And this was a time when Karnataka had thought of improving the business environment long before the rest of India had even thought of it. Karnataka counts as one of the more progressive frontline states in India. PAC has been privileged to partner in some of its good governance endeavors. I want to acknowledge the steadfast support that PAC has received from several senior officers of the government of Karnataka who are present here today. I want to acknowledge ISN Prasad, the additional Chief Secretary of Finance, who has been a friend, philosopher, and guide. Amlan Biswas, who has given PAC the recognition it deserves as a knowledge partner. Selva Kumar, another fine young officer who has been a friend of Public Affairs Center. There are others who are not present here, chief among them, the Chief Secretary of the Government of Karnataka. It gives me great pride when I attend meetings in the state government and more recently in a meeting relating to the sustainable development goals, when all the secretaries to the government of India were present, the chief secretary endorsing the work of Public Affairs Center. There's no greater tribute to PAC and Dr. Paul than that. I see several other former IAS officers who have been great reformers in their own right and who are friends of PAC. Among them, I want to acknowledge Mr. Shantanu Kansal, Mr. Srinivas Murthy, Mr. K. Jairaj, and Mr. Irabotu Venkataya, who have always risen to the cause of the Public Affairs Center, who have never missed an opportunity to help, and most important, who have always attended PAC events. We look forward to your continued support. Similarly, Gopal Hosur, a friend, not just of mine, but of the PACs here, I want to acknowledge him. Vinod Vyasulu, who started CBPS, is here. He's been a long friend of, he's been a friend of PAC for very long. I want to acknowledge him. All of you have helped PAC grow into a credible and respected nonprofit think tank. There are many others who have traveled with Public Affairs Center in the last 25 years, but time constrains me from dwelling on all of them. Suffice to say that they are all people who believed, to paraphrase the Dalai Lama, it is not enough to be compassionate, we must act. And act we did together. Let me now turn briefly to the major milestones that PAC has achieved in the last 25 years. In 1994, the first citizen report card, a social accountability tool pioneered by Dr. Samuel Paul, was used to assess the state of public services in Bangalore City, soon followed by PAC's first research report in 1995. At the turn of the century in 2000, as a measure of our faith that children are the future of India, PAC established the Children's Movement for Civic Awareness. Rahul Dravid was its brand ambassador. We wanted him to be here today, but he was traveling. I'm happy to say that the movement met with such remarkable success that CMCA is today an independent and active organization. In 2003, the Public Affairs Foundation was established. As a sister organization of the PAC, the PAF is a nonprofit company that works in tandem with us. In 2004, the World Bank, and in its annual World Development Report titled Making Services Work for the Poor, recognized the work of the Public Affairs Center and commended the CRC as a transformational social accountability tool to hold the state to account. In 2006, PAC formed the Coalition Against Corruption. This has proved useful because PAC helped change the paradigm from policing to influencing systemic changes to combat corruption. Between 2007 and 2015, the center made the transition to an action research-based organization. During this period, PAC took wing and expanded its influence across South Asia. PAC has become a part of South-South cooperation amongst think tanks. We are an important member of the think tank initiative launched by the IDRC of Canada and of Southern Voice, two of the most powerful NGO platforms in the Global South. In 2016, we launched the Public Affairs Index that has since become our flagship project. I want to acknowledge Dr. C.K. Matthew, who as a senior fellow pioneered this effort. Since 2017, important initiatives have been ushered in by the Board of the Public Affairs Center. These have helped place PAC firmly on the path of enhancing its ability to respond effectively to the future public policy and governance challenges. A key initiative was to adopt the Sustainable Development Goals Framework as the organizing principle for PAC's future work. Our focus moving forward will be to address the problem of exclusion that is increasingly manifesting in development outcomes across the country, specifically in school education, primary health, and livelihoods. In 2018, PAC undertook the first CSR project supported by the Toyota Motor Corporation. I want to acknowledge Mr. Shekhar Vishwanathan, Vice Chairman TKM, and his continued admiration for and support to PAC. This is one area, corporate social responsibility, that we will be venturing into in a much bigger way in the ensuing years. Before I conclude, I must ask the question, what does the future look like? Since October 2017, Dr. Kasturi Rangan took over as chairman. His effort has been to propel PAC to a higher and more scientific trajectory. I want to acknowledge the remarkable guidance and support that I receive from you, sir. And the transformative influence he exerts in providing the strategic direction to the PAC for the future. He has emphasized the importance of scientific rigor in our research, urged us to go beyond regression analysis and adapt diverse modes of predictive analysis, and opened our eyes to the immense power of empirical approaches and the application of data science and simulation models for the public good. These will be the future directions of the Public Affairs Center. Thank you all for joining us today, and a very warm welcome once again.